Obaseki swears in 73 new appointees. Hodges, diligent. Hello, my amazing family. Be thankful for closed doors, detours, and roadblocks. They protect you from the path and places not made for use. Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. The Edo State Governor, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, on Thursday, swearing newly appointed political aides, charging them to be of good conduct and ensure the delivery of quality service to Edo people. The appointees include Mrs. Philomena Iheye, who was appointed as the political advisor, Edo Central, as well as 21 senior special assistants and 51 special assistants. The aides were drawn from the 51 wards in the 5 local government areas of Edo Central Senatorial District, following the harmonization of the People's Democratic Party by leaders in the Senatorial District. Speaking at the swearing-in ceremony in Ira, the headquarters of Esan Central Local Government Area, Obaseki said the appointment into the various political positions was a result of their credibility and track record. He said the appointment this time around is quite different from what it used to be. The political leaders in your wards have found you worthy to get you shortlisted, going by the clear guidelines we issued to them to carry out the selection. You would recall our visit to the various wards trying to brainstorm with party leaders on the parameters to be used for the selection. We met them and they spoke to us of their needs, which of course I promised to fulfill. Reiterating the need to give back to the society, the governor charged the new appointees to attract socio-economic development to their communities, especially in the areas of health, education, infrastructure, and security, among others. Obaseki said, "You are not called to make money in government, but to work for your people. The structure is that special assistants must report to my office weekly through your senior special assistants to give me an update on your activities from the constituencies and wards that you serve." Obaseki added, "One of the senior special assistants, each of them shall be assigned to work with security agencies such as the police, the state security services, and civil defense. Their duties would be to report the security situation in their environment." Please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time. Thank you. He, however, expressed disappointment over the low turnout of Esan Central voters during the PDP e-registration exercise. In his remarks, the senator representing Esan Central at the National Assembly, Senator Clifford Odier, thanked the governor for his laudable infrastructural projects, pledging the readiness of the Esan people to reciprocate the governor's kind gestures by collaborating with him towards the realization of the Making Edo Great Again agenda. On his part, Chairman of Edo PDP, Anthony Eziagbemi, while commending Obaseki for fulfilling his electionary promises, assured the Esan people of the governor's determination to improve their socio-economic well-being. It can be recorded that after 1 year of his inauguration for a second term in office, Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki is failed to select commissioners. The unusual style of governance is no longer acceptable to the people of South South. Nearly a year after Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki was re-elected into a second term, the administration is led by three musketeers: Obaseki, his deputy Philip Shahibu, and Osarodia Oge, a lawyer as secretary to the state government, SSG. During his inauguration speech, The governor promised to get right to work and continue his administration's development efforts. On November 14, 2020, Obaseki reappointed Oge as SSG, calling Oge's appointment as the sole political appointment made for now. All other appointments, he said, would be rescheduled for the first week of February 2021, a date that has yet to be confirmed. The governor deflected from the All Progressive Congress APC to the People's Democratic Party PDP on June 19, 2020, after the governorship screening panel in Abuja disqualified him, while Comrade Adam Sushamole was the party's national chairman APC. Leaders of PDP welcomed Obaseki into the party while they prevailed on three frontline governorship aspirants, including the billionaire philanthropist Kenneth Imaswogbo, an Abuja-based lawyer, to step down for the new bride, which they voluntarily did as a mark of respect for leaders of the party, thereby preparing for 2024 battle. So, the first week of February 2021 passed without Obaseki forming a cabinet, citing his deflection from the APC to the PDP and the need for harmonization among Edo PDP's key stakeholders as excuses. After members of the harmonization committee submitted their reports, if I can recall, April was proposed as a new date for forming the cabinet, but the undemocratic suspension of Edo PDP chairman Dr. Tony Ezeagbemi over a feud with Obaseki, who planned to dissolve the party's executives at the world local government and state levels, caused confusion. Later, Ezeagbemi was reinstated. But please don't forget to give us a like or thumbs up if this is the first time here. Thank you. So early last month, the governor, Godwin Obaseki, announced the first batch of appointments. And just yesterday, the governor has sworn in those appointees. Platinum Post reports that it took the governor, Godwin Obaseki, a year after winning his re-election to appoint commissioners that were sworn in some few hours ago. The issue of appointments is said to be the major cause of the crisis rocking the ruling People's Democratic Party, PDP, in Edo State, as many of top party chieftains accused the governor of running a one-man show. Please don't forget to give us a like or a thumbs up, and please hit on the notification button for more authentic news. I'm your number one news blog. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.